he finished off that statement basically sending out a warning.
Yeah.
A warning to whoever the future president is.
Good luck.
Yeah, basically good luck with what you're going to find at the club.
I wish you the best of luck. I hope this club returns to what it once was. It won't be easy.
Tough words from Lionel Messi. I think it's more clear than ever that he is going
to
leave.
Hello guys, welcome back to El Merengue. Today's going to be a bit of a different video. It's going to be Messi's interview, an unfiltered interview, to potentially see a lot of the things Barcelona has been sweeping under the rug, potentially get exposed. I don't know what to expect.
Very curious. Hope we could be getting a lot of insight and light into Messi's future at Barcelona. Obviously, we're going to be doing the translation because it's going to be in Spanish, the analysis, and kind of give our opinions. So we don't really know how long this video will be. I believe the interview is going to be an hour long, so hopefully we can shorten this video. We don't want to obviously make it that long. But guys, with that being said, okay, we are back. Finally, we're gonna get started.
There we go.
Time to begin. Ooh. So real quick, first thing that they're asking him is how he likes to celebrate Christmas and like the holidays.
How's his family doing?
Exactly.
Where they're at.
So real quick to recap what just happened right there. The interviewer asked him, was telling us how he had asked Messi for an interview a long time ago when the pandemic started, and Messi initially said no. But he did tell him, I'll give you an interview at some point. And the interviewer goes to say that he was very shocked when Messi said that when Messi told and contacted him back saying that he would agree to the interview basically after they lost to Cadiz and to Juventus in that same week. So what could this potentially hint at? Maybe like negative emotions that were going through Messi's head, that he was like, you know what? I need to talk. I need to get this interview out. Okay, so let's move on. Let's keep hearing. Interviewer kissing ass a little bit, making sure Messi will give out answers. He's like, before we proceed and you hate us, please just sign this jersey before I expose you a little more. So I think we're seeing a very sincere side of Messi. He said Barcelona's his life, got there when he was 13 years old, thanking the club for everything they've done for him. That's where he grew, he learned a lot of things. Yeah. Messi admitting that Barcelona is financially really bad. Messi's words. He's basically saying that he's not faking anything. He's saying whatever he's feeling, he's showing it. Which I don't know if that's entirely true. He says he's the type of guy that anytime something like bad would happen, he's the type of guy to just kind of keep it to himself, not really let it out, and like kind of like let it eat himself up. If that makes any sense. Asking him what it's like to play in an empty stadium, he says right away, horrible. And I've always wondered, if fans were present, how would he be feeling any different, right? Fans probably would have wrapped him in a blanket and made him feel more at home, been like, Messi, don't leave, you know, we want you to stay. But every time he enters the stadium, it's empty, and all he hears is nothing.
Yeah.
He's showing a bit of frustration that they never think on the actual footballer themselves.
Players.
It's all about what the TV wants, TV, right? Completing the the contracts and all that. So this is actually probably one of the biggest questions that they've asked, which was, would you send that fax that you sent to the club that basically stated that you wanted to leave the club officially? Would you do it again? And what was his response?
Straight up, yes. He's
without hesitating, he said yes.
It's a way of making it official. He said that he's been talking to, you know, the Bartomeu, the board of directors.
Back in the den,
For like the past 6 months before that, telling him, look, man, I'm planning on leaving. Help me.
Yeah.
Help me leave. And then they were always like, no, yeah, we'll get to it eventually. No. Until he just got fed up, and it was the way of making it official.
Yeah. So real quick, now they kind of brought up how, if you know, what his emotions, what his feelings were when in the summer many fans, many people questioned whether he was a true loyal like Barcelona fan,
to the city, to the club, to everything.
Yeah,
and to which he said that for the most part, he's earned everything he's gotten from the club. He's earned from his actions, from his,
yes,
you know, he's earned in the past.
It's not like I was just handed those things by the club and like my life is in debt to the club because of the things that they've helped me achieve that I also in part achieved on my own, right? So I do understand that. And then he also went on to say that which is, you know, something that's, I think, pretty well known and pretty well understood by most people by now. But his reasoning behind wanting to leave, that he knew this would be a year of transition at the club.
Yeah.
And with a lot of new people, a lot of new faces, a lot of young people. And he wants to, being that these are, you know, his final years of his career, you know, not last one, but final years. He wants to position himself in a place where he can compete for the most titles he can, compete for the Champions League again, compete to be the, you know, Ballon d'Or once again, win the league, all those type of things. And I think that we know as fans, Barcelona is not the best position at right now. And also that they wanted to make him out to be like the bad guy of the movie. So right now,
he pretty much said that he tried to do it the right way by letting the club know. He thought of the fans when acting, you know, yeah, like he thought of the fans before, like fully decision. Committing. He talked to his family. They didn't want to leave.
Mm-hmm.
He reminiscing on the city and how perfect the city is tailored to what he wants. The temperature, you know, the lifestyle.
The people. Yeah.
Everything. It's such a hard decision, but almost hinting at the fact that, like, it's done. It's a done deal in his head.
Almost hinting like he's going to reveal where he's going to go to in the coming minutes or something. We'll have to see. And then Messi now giving kind of his opinion on the Barcelona sale of Suarez, showing how frustrated and pissed he was at the club for letting him go for free, paying him the rest of his years, and not only that, but giving him to a rival team that's going to be
fighting the same titles.
The same objective, same titles as Barcelona in La Liga and the Champions League.
Ending by saying he wasn't mad at necessarily the fact that Suarez left, the fact that they sold him, but how and to who they sold him.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Look at his body language.
Yeah, yeah. He's like looking down.
Before moving on to this question that's pretty interesting, they did ask him about Bartomeu, and right away, Messi's body language said it all. He right away became
reserved,
looked down, and said that that's something, a topic he doesn't want to talk about. Clearly, he is not fond of Bartomeu at all.
Doesn't want to expose what happens in closed doors. Again, kind of hinting at what he said earlier of, you know, keeping those emotions to himself.
Yes, exactly.
And now we're getting to the question.
Another big question, which obviously he's still asking, so I don't fully know how he's going to finish asking it. But it has to do with the rumors that came out earlier, a couple months ago.
A little over a year.
Yeah, saying that Barcelona would pay people to talk bad about certain players in the club. So let's see like what he has to say about it. So Messi's response essentially to that was that he didn't really put too much focus on it. He didn't really care to waste time on that.
The least of his worries with everything going around. And then the interviewer asked him, or like pretty much said, like, look, I'm asking you this question. I'm trying to find the moment that it clicked. The moment that you said you no longer want to be a Barcelona. To which Messi says, there isn't a moment. It's been a chronic issue. Whether it's starting from how we have been eliminated from Champions League's bunch of issues.
La Liga, it's just like obviously Bartomeu, the way he's treated the club and the players, stuff like that. It's been a chronic thing. It's never something that said, I need to get out of this team. It's just a chronic thing. So one of the big questions that was just asked that was asked around the time that he said that he was going to end up staying at the club, which I personally asked myself, and I said it before, which was, well, maybe Messi realized that he was actually in the wrong, and if he went to a trial against Barcelona, he realized he wouldn't win because the contract did state that certain things, and thus he decided to just end up staying, which he affirmatively said that is not true. He was like, I decided to stay for other reasons, even though knowing that if we went to trial, I would 100% win that trial, and that's probably one of the big reasons why he didn't want to go and maybe humiliate Barcelona in that sense. He had talked to many different lawyers, not just the lawyer that he had been working with, but many different lawyers that had assured him that he was in the right.
He said he didn't want to leave Barcelona in that note.
Yeah. Another interesting question that was asked was whether Messi maintains himself in contact with Pep Guardiola, which to he answered yes.
But he said nothing of the sorts of transferring to City. The conversations are more friendly of how Pep Guardiola's time has been at City, how whatever things happening in Barcelona.
Yes.
Nothing suggesting a link.
Yes. But then does go and admit that he is the best coach he's ever had.
It was a little weird. He said he had the bad luck of having to what Messi considers the two best managers, Luis Enrique and Pep Guardiola, back to back.
Yes.
I don't really get why it's a bad thing, but...
Well, I think he's saying that he grew up too fast, and now maybe he's seeing that every other coach that he has, he kind of looks down upon them, mm-hmm. and he doesn't think they're too good, and that's why he's saying it, bad luck, because now everyone else that I meet is just kind of like, oh, you're not as good. Okay. So I think that's what he meant by, I had the bad luck of doing that. He did go also and explain how he thinks Pep was the best because of the way he prepared the games prior to the game, right? Whether it was, you know, how you were going to go out there and defend as a team, how you were going to attack. He would always tell you, you know, where to be, where the holes are in the game, how the rhythm, the vibe of that game is going, and how to approach that specific moment. And that's why he considered him, you know, one of the best coaches. So this next part I thought was pretty interesting, in which they asked him that in his last interview that he gave a couple months ago, he basically went out and basically said that Barcelona didn't have a project, that any holes that they had, they would just put up any quick patch, any easy fix. And so then he went on to ask if he thinks that Ronald Koeman was actually a project, you know, if there was actually a project behind that.
To which I found Messi's answer very, very interesting. He said, yes, on Ronald Koeman, there is more of a project. He has more of an idea where he wants to take his team, Ronald Koeman's team.
Mm-hmm. In a direction. I didn't catch that.
Not our team. It's Ronald Koeman's team.
Interesting. I didn't catch it in that sense.
I have been getting that sensation that Messi is more...
He feels like an outsider.
Just kind of guest playing.
Yeah. Which is it's very true. And I feel like that's kind of like the theme in the sense that I get as this interview kind of goes on. That Messi just slowly detaching himself from the team. You know, he's saying... He's starting to just be like, yeah, well, I was part of that team. But now he's showing us how he's moving on. I think that is definitely his final decision. So now he was essentially asked if he had a president that he would rather be elected, and that kind of that question basically led from another question in which the interviewer was asking Messi what his opinion was on those who said that Messi should have been sold this summer, which he basically didn't fully answer. He kind of like just once again detached himself from that. He said like, no, like, you know, I don't think that would do any good to the club if I answer that right now or anything. So he basically didn't want to answer that. But then he kind of went on to answer the question about the president, if he had any president in his favor. And so he basically said, no, because if I did, then it would show that I have an influence on running the club and stuff, which is basically the same reaction I had. The moment he asked the question, I was like, he better not answer this, because that's clearly showing that he has an influence on how he wants the club to be run. So I'm glad he answered that.
But I want to break down the question a little bit further. He asked them if he was going to go vote for the presidential election, to which Messi pretty much said, he didn't straight up say no, but he was like, I don't know, I'm not really planning on it. I mean, again, completely detaching himself from the club, wishing... Go ahead.
Yeah, well, then I think you were going to say finish it off, but what I was going to say is he finished off that statement basically sending out a warning.
Yeah.
A warning to whoever the future president is.
Good luck.
Yeah, basically good luck with what you're going to find at the club.
I wish you the best of luck. I hope this club returns to what it once was. It won't be easy.
Tough words from Lionel Messi. So real quick, before more information happens, because I feel like a lot of interesting stuff just happened right now. Oh man, I don't even know where to start. So in my opinion, I felt like I saw Messi get a little bit defensive right now.
Yeah.
Kind of questioning the interviewer why he asked them that. And essentially what Messi was asking him, he's like, okay, why did you ask me that?
And ask him if he had been attached to any president directly. Like,
yes.
You know, a lot of players attach themselves to a presidential election. You know, like Xavi, like Puyol, attach themselves to a specific president to try to get them elected.
Yes. And I think the explanation that the interviewer said for why he asked him that is because he was, which sounds completely logical to me, saying, well, it would make sense to me that a president that
is trying to get elected,
that one of their goals is trying to get elected, but one of their main goals is to keep Lionel Messi at the club, should have probably already contacted you, said, hey, because that's one of my main goals, I think it's smart that I contact you and tell you that stuff. And basically, we got a Messi that was very hesitant to how he wanted to respond to that, which leads me to think he's not fully saying the entire truth or something. Which then the interviewer went to ask him, like, because, you know, we've been getting, you know, full, you know, 100% truthful answers, and to which Messi looked away. His body language, you know, I'm not trying to call him a liar and that he hasn't said, like, the truth in this interview, but his body language was a little bit interesting, kind of looking away with a slight grin, repositioning himself in his seat, saying, like, which kind of goes to show, like, okay, I am not comfortable with what you just asked. Let me reposition myself to make myself a little more comfortable. So clearly goes to show that Messi got uncomfortable with that question to whether he had answered everything that has been asked truthfully. I find that pretty interesting. And that goes back to maybe he has contacted a certain president. Maybe he, because he first said that he hadn't. And now this leads up to like the next part, which was the interviewer asked Messi, what if the president says, hey, if I get elected, I'm going to bring Xavi.
As a club, as a manager.
As a manager. To which Messi...
And they asked him, would you stay?
Yeah, well, yeah, would you stay if Xavi comes as a manager? And he kind of like, he laughed. I want to say, what are you taking that?
He thought it through. He thought it through. He was hesitant.
He was hesitant. He didn't know how to answer.
Almost as if he wanted to say yes, but didn't want to influence anything.
Yeah. Very interesting. It's hard to read between the lines, which is what we're trying to do here. It was definitely a tough one. They're pressing him on. This interview is getting very interesting. They're starting to press him on Neymar, asking him, "What if, you know, the president said that we're going to bring Neymar?" And Messi showing his resistance, saying that's going to be very complicated.
Money.
PSG has a lot of money, stuff like that.
Also saying that it's going to require a lot more than a Neymar to bring this club back to what it once was.
Yes. Very interesting stuff. Let's see if he potentially reveals something about PSG.
The interview is pressing that connection between Neymar, saying, oh, you know, but Neymar, like, he was like, oh, yeah, but I'm sure Neymar wants to come or at least play with you, mm-hmm. you know, recently mentioned.
Yeah,
let's see.
Something very interesting that I want to say is, I don't know if you've noticed, but have you noticed how much Messi has started smiling ever since Neymar and Suarez were brought up?
He's kind of laughing.
He got a little more comfortable. He felt comfortable just with hearing their names and associating them together and playing again. I just want to know how happy Messi appeared. So I think this question kind of like finalizes the type of stuff that we wanted to get out of the interview, in which he asks him, because technically Messi, because his contract is running out, once January hits, he can start negotiating with whatever team he wants, a potential transfer. And when he was asked whether he was going to start negotiating with the team, he basically said no, that he's going to wait until the season's over to basically find out what, you know, what ends up happening. And so while that is Messi's answer, I do have my own take on that. I don't think in any world could Messi really come out and say, yes, I'm already negotiating with another team. Because think of what that would do for the rest of the season. Mm-hmm. It would destroy Barcelona's season. So, of course, Messi cannot go out and say to the public, yes, I'm already negotiating with Man City or PSG or, you know, whoever else. And I think as fans, as people, we wanted to watch this interview, we wanted him to say that, but realistically, he was never going to answer such a question, right? So, yes, while he's saying he has not and he's going to wait till the end of the season, I have my doubts on that.
What I took away from it is that he's 99% sure going to leave at the end of the season, right? Probably in the summer, whenever the season concludes, but it won't happen this January, winter transfer season.
Oh, no, definitely not. So, to summarize what just happened right now, the interviewer basically said, I have a Christmas present for you. He pulls out a guide to the cities of Manchester and Paris and says, which one would you like to keep?
Yeah, one or the other.
Exactly.
Messi takes a glance at the Paris one first.
Yes.
Closes it. Takes a glance at the Manchester one. Puts the Paris one on top of the Manchester one, sets him aside, kind of smirking-ish, I don't know.
Yes. And then proceeds to kind of talk about how he would one day like to return to Barcelona to be involved with the club in certain things, which obviously the next question is, well, you just said return. What do you mean by that? And which he kind of veered off pretty nicely, saying that, well, he does want to experience life, what it'd be like in the United States. There has been talks before about him, you know, going back to Argentina to retire there and all that stuff. So he definitely opened up way for playing at the MLS at some point in his life. But then he was asked, he's like, okay, well, you're talking about the MLS, but could we ever see you at the Premier League, the Ligue 1, you know, the French League at any point? To which you basically finalized an answer as, I'm not sure yet.
But he did say right before that, he was like, I don't think it would be smart to say my future. And then he said, because I don't exactly know where that's going to be.
He quickly shuts off the opportunity for Real Madrid and Atletico, but he does not shut off for PSG or Manchester. And that is the end. A pretty good interview, I would say. I think in the end, while he didn't officially reveal any specific answers to where he could leave, I think it's more clear than ever that he is going to leave.
Yeah. It was a much different interview than the one that happened a few months ago, whereas that one was definitely a bit more staged. The questions looked a bit more predetermined for him to
say what he wanted to say to basically the club.
These questions, this interview was definitely trying to put Messi on his edge, you know, bringing the gifts out, throwing some wild cards in there, which I think we got a pretty good understanding of who Messi is, his emotions, his plans for the future, vague plans for the future. An eye-opening interview for sure.
For sure. Guys, if you are new to the channel, obviously he is a Barcelona fan. I'm a Real Madrid fan, so you get the opinions from both sides. We obviously have a lot of other content where we like to do live reactions to the majority of the big games for Barcelona or Real Madrid, and then do analysis, pre-game analysis, post-game analysis for their other games. Like I said, guys, if you made it this far in the video and you enjoyed it, make sure you hit that like button down below. Subscribe as well, of course. Of course, we want you to help us keep growing, reach a wider audience. And do you have any final words?
Potentially, stay tuned for a live stream on Tuesday. Potentially.
A live stream for Barcelona's game against Eibar on Tuesday. We will definitely keep you guys more updated. But until then, peace out.